Hi friends, in this video we are going to have a look into the editorials that appeared on 13th of February. The first article which we are going to discuss is about the inequalities existing in the adaptation mechanisms for climate change. And the article is titled Adapting Better to Climate Change. What is adaptation? Actions that minimize or prevent the negative impacts of climate change is called as adaptation. And this adaptation needs financing, and the funds for adaptation initiatives are done by the financial organizations which are listed in Article 11 of UNFCCC. And these Article 11 institution includes Global Environmental Facility, Green Climate Fund, Special Climate Change Fund, Least Developed Country Fund, and Adaptation Fund under Kyoto Protocol. And this adaptation is done through, the financing is done by these organizations defined in Article 11, and we have other mechanisms based on which the adaptation process are being undertaken. The mechanisms are mainly National Adaptation Plan, National Adaptation Programs of Action, Can-Can Adaptation Framework, Nairobi Work Program, Development and Transfer of Technology, and the last is Financing, Technology and Capacity Building Initiative of UNFCCC. The author says that there is a huge power play in adaptation which is bringing in inequality. The adaptation process begin by studying the local impacts of the climate change and studying the vulnerabilities faced by the local community, by the local ecosystem, and it tries to address the problems based on this context. And 2010, a survey undertaken by James Ford, it found disparities in distribution of benefits arising out of adaptation projects. The adaptation projects undertaken by UNFCCC is also not looking into the disparity and inequality arising out of benefits of adaptation mechanisms. And Benjamin Sovacool has undertaken a study to analyze the influence of multi-scale political forces in economic distribution. And his focus was mainly on power struggles among people fighting for limited resources. And Sovacool study was based on 4 E's. And the first E is enclosure, the second is exclusion, the third is encroachment, the fourth is entrenchment. The first E is enclosure, in which the private player acquire control over a public property and they expand their authority over that public property. And the second E is exclusion. Exclusion is the stakeholders getting marginalized or victimized, and they are being kept out of decision making. This is exclusion. The third E is encroachment. Encroachment is normally like when the adaptation projects is interfering with the existing ecosystem and disturbing the ecological services provided by that ecosystem, resulting in inadvertently resulting in greenhouse gas emissions. This is encroachment. The fourth is entrenchment. Entrenchment is a situation where the already marginalized are getting more worse by the intervention. So I have displayed a few examples based on which Sovacool has undertaken the study. The first example from Tanzania, the marine protection areas to protect coral reefs, it impacted a fishing community, and this shows the theme of encroachment. And in Australia, the lands of aborigines were handed over to the desalination plant. This is an example for enclosure. The third was in Norway. The local community, they went underrepresented in the coastal planning process. This forms an example for exclusion. The fourth example is from USA, where a barrier against the sea to restrict the erosion was built against the wishes of community. This also forms an example of exclusion. The fifth example is in Kenya, where the disaster relief fund, we all know Kenya faced a big cyclone this year, and the distribution of disaster relief fund in Kenya, it showed a sign of disparity, where the rich urban people received the aids first and the rural people received it later. This created more problem. This is an example of entrenchment. So what is the way ahead? The author feels that politics and power struggle are the inherent part of the adaptation projects. Author is also feeling that there should be a prior informed consent taken from the stakeholders before undertaking any project. India should learn more from the example cited above, because India has its own economic inequality, and the inequality arising out of adaptation projects would make things even worse. We should take adequate measures to reduce the adverse effects of adaptation project. Normally what we do is, we always believe that, normally what we believe is science and technology has solution for everything. It is partially true, but we are not considering the ramification and other negative fallouts of technology in bringing social and political solutions. Normally we perceive technology as elixir for all the problems existing. But this is partially true, but while considering technology to be a solution, we should consider the ramifications and negative fallouts of technology in the social and political conditions. Whenever the agencies undertake adaptation projects, they study the vulnerability and cost of the projects, and they normally miss out issues around equity, justice and social hierarchies. This should be avoided, and this should be avoided. Focusing on equity, justice and social hierarchy related problems will help in reducing the gap, reducing the inequality between the different communities. The forces of political economy and ecology, which are integral part of our societies, cannot be wished away when considering adaptation projects. The next article is on the nuclear posture review released by United States of America. The article is titled More Nukes. So what is nuclear posture review? Nuclear posture review is a process which determines the role of nuclear weapons in United States security strategy. The first nuclear posture review was released in 1994. And these NPR can be an indicator for the level of military aggressiveness of US presidents. The last NPR was released by President Obama, who was dreaming for a world without nuclear weapons. And the NPR also indicated his aspirations of a world without nuclear weapons. But the recent NPR by President Donald Trump, it shows the aggressiveness of Donald Trump, and it widens the extreme circumstances to include the recent nuclear posture review released by President Donald Trump. It has included non-nuclear aggression on, it has included, it has proposed to use nuclear weapons on nuclear weapons even on non-nuclear aggressions made by enemies of US on American civil and military infrastructure. And President Trump has proposed to use low yield nuclear weapons over the non-nuclear weapon countries. And what is the nuclear weapons vary in sizes. The sizes of nuclear weapon is defined by the size of the nuclear fissile material it possesses. The low yield nuclear weapon possesses nuclear fuel of 15 kiloton. And this low yield weapon was the one that was used in Hiroshima in 1945. And in the image present in the slide, I have shown the mushroom cloud infamously associated with nuclear weapons of varying nuclear weapon sizes. A low yield nuclear weapon releases a mushroom cloud of this size, and a nuclear weapon of 15,000 kiloton releases a mushroom cloud of this humongous size. In the image present in the slide, I have given the image shows us the difference between the different nuclear weapons based on the surface detonation cloud height versus yield. A low yield nuclear weapon releases a detonation cloud of 6 kilometers height, and a very high yield nuclear weapon of the capacity of 15 megaton releases a detonation cloud height of somewhere around 35 kilometers. This shows the intensity of nuclear weapons. The world is witnessing increasing arms race recent past. This is evident from the development of hypersonic glider developed by China and hypersonic nuclear missile developed by Russia. The recent announcement keeps US away from the moral ground of being compliant to the non-proliferation regime. And apart from the security perspective, it has also a trade perspective into the decision. The trade perspective is that the American army modernization is of $1 trillion value. So this will improve the American economy. And also this NPR gives the premises to develop usable nukes. The author says that the 21st century weapon dynamics is based on producing high-intensity small weapons. This arms race is fueled by growing strategic apprehensions between different countries. In order to safeguard, in order to prevent U.S. from being attacked by Iran, U.S. set up a ballistic missile defense in Romania and Poland. And this is also very close to Russia. And setting up ballistic missile defense in its neighborhood is not going well with China. Setting up a ballistic missile in its closer vicinity is not going well with Russia. Also, the NATO has been expanding. The North Atlantic Treaty Organization is expanding, and it has included the erstwhile Soviet Union countries and the present East European countries like Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania. This has created apprehensions among the Russians, and this has fueled the arms race. And to conclude with, the nuclear posture review has blurred the distinction between the conventional and nuclear conflicts.